I'm present with pneumonia jaundice. The other, they become exposed to oxidants, مثل drugs, مثل viruses, ويسووا شوية hemolysis, acute, what we call acute hemolysis. So G6PD in neonatal jaundice, acute hemolysis, and then in acute hemolysis precipitated by infection or by drugs or by food. وكل الناس عارفة طبعا الفود والفول يعني. Yeah, so الآن إحنا نعرف إنه ممكن نفتالين, ممكن الحنة, ممكن كذا. يعني هذا these are there has been reports obvious. وفعلا النفتالين حتى لما يشموا ريحته بعض الأحيان يعني. بالنسبة لكن ما ضروري إنه مع يعني أنا عندي ولد عنده G6PD, لكن هذا البولز هذا اللي تسوى في الحالة يعني بعض الأحيان تكون موجودة في البيت والحمد لله ما حس إنه هو is affected يعني. فهو هذا الإشكالية إنه there are 600 mutations في G6PD. وكلهم مختلفة الميديترينيان والأفريكان وكذا and they vary. ما كل الناس يتأثروا بالفول وما كل الناس يتأثروا بالحنة ولا كل الناس, فعلى كل حال يعني تأخذوا بي. لكن بشكل عام it's not a life threatening. ما هذا أنا أقدر أقول هذا صح. لما يجي في الأضلت شوي يمكن يسوي لكم رينال فيل لأن الهيموليسيز بلوك ذا كيدنيز and it can cause. We have seen يمكن كل سنتين يجينا حالة واحدة واحد أخذ فول أخضر وكذا وراح له G6PD هيموليسيز. والفيروس اللي ما نقدر نعم خاصة عند الأطفال لو 5 سنوات 6 سنوات 4 سنوات يجيهم فيروسات it may precipitate hemolysis it require يمكن بعض المرضى يكون require transfusion. في العادة it's a self-limiting ويعطيك تعطوه فوليك أسيد ويروح المشكلة. في عندكم مجموعة أخرى اللي يسموها chronic non-spherocytic hemolysis. ناس عندهم يكون الهيموغلوبين مالهم شوية متدني ويكون عندهم طحال كبيرة, لكن هؤلاء الناس احنا ما نشوفهم. يبدو انه التايب اوف ميوتيشن اللي موجود عندنا ما تسبب مثل هذا الشكل. يكون عندهم هيموغلوبين شويه متدني دائما وعندهم نون سفيروسيتيك, يعني ما يكون في سفيروسايت. السفيروسايت هي ساين اوف انترافاسكولار هيموليسيس. زين, فهذا الجي 6 بي دي انا يمكن ما راح ارجع عليه مره اخرى. ايوه, فهو شوفي انت احنا في عمان we do only the color change, we do screening, we don't quantify the G6PD. معايا؟ يعني ما نقيس كم معدل انزيم, وعندنا رينج اذا كان هذا الكلر ممكن يكون اقل من 30%. عندنا رينج فما لانه quantification of it's ما إنه غالي وإحنا نعمله, لكن يمكن تعملي في كل سنتين أو 3 سنوات حالة واحدة محتاجة أنت يو quantify. فبالتالي دائما يكون ممكن يعطيك هذا الرينج مال الأكسيدنت كالر حال الفور G6PD screening إنه ممكن يكون أقل من 30%, لكن doesn't really quantify it for you. فإذا كان deficient معناه أقل من 30%, بينما إذا كان sufficient ونورمال above 30%. لكن ممكن يكون مرضى عندهم 10 ويمشوا حالهم وكذا. فهل this is وخاصة عند النساء إنه إذا كان حاملات لأنه it's an X-linked ممكن يكون حاملات ممكن يكونوا lower level مالهم عن النورمال. فهمتي ومعاي أنت؟ فهو أصلا نحن نحط قطرة من الدم and we see the color change إن هل هذا positive ولا negative. ما نقدر نخبرك إن هذا عنده level كذا وكذا ولا عنده level كذا وكذا ولا عنده level كذا وكذا. نقدر نسويه لكن this is a different test فحص. So it's a screening test only.
You will give the patient such
this is really deficient. As deficient. You are ready? أنت جاهز ولا إيش؟ لا مستعد كأن عسكري هذا. طيب إحنا إذا نبدأ بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. فالهيموغلوبين ديسوردر طبعا عشان أحسن أجلس لا ولا أقوم. ما شاء الله so everything is there. طيب okay so what we are going to do today is the hemoglobin disorders. Okay. طبعا what is hemoglobin? Hemoglobin is the substance that is inside the red cell. اوكي في خلايا الدم الحمراء they are not really cells by definition because they are not able to reproduce يعني ما فيهم نيوكلياس ما فيهم كذا they مخلوقين they are created for 120 days بعدين they die okay you know why they die because they have inside them preformed what we call preformed enzymes and other proteins and when it get depleted they cannot do their jobs so the macrophages select them and they die secondly why they die because they pass through these small vessels or vessels in the ear or in the brain very tiny vessels or in the blood or in the and they have to navigate blood vessels هم حجمهم 1/3 of their size يعني دخلوا في شعيرات اقل من حجمهم okay so when they're doing that they get squeezed they squeeze themselves okay and they squeeze themselves because they have this ability what we call rheolic r-h-e-o-l-i-c rheolic ability you know, they squeeze that they mold themselves okay حتى يدخلوا من خلال الشعيرات الدمويه لما smaller than their size now what happened during that time you know, they get damaged okay فبالتالي they die okay هذه كلها مقدمات يعني okay so they die but inside the red cell عندهم الهيموغلوبين and what does the hemoglobin do it delivers oxygen that's what it does okay and it has enzymes and other protein that support its function معايا فلذلك لما ينقص الجي 6 بي دي ال red cell cannot deal with the oxidative stress so that's why it get hemolyzed and die or the membrane get damaged because it pass through blood vessel that is smaller than their size and so they are eaten by the macrophages and then they die now imagine if that cell is altered in its shape like sickle cell then it die faster واضح so in sickle in me and you it's 120 but in sickle how many days it lives 20 days or 17 days okay فلازم so the bone marrow has to produce more cells so there are the hemoglobin abnormality is divided into three groups into structural and quantitative and enzymes okay structure معناه تغيير في structure اتغيرت من biconcave الى sickle فهذا structure or quantity احنا عندنا الله سبحانه وتعالى خلق الهيموغلوبين في two chain الفا and بيتا عنده أربعة يعني اثنين من الفا اثنين من بيتا okay two of alpha two of beta now if this is one issue the other issue that الله سبحانه وتعالى خلق الفا في جانب وبيتا في جانب okay so one alpha is in one chromosome and beta is in another chromosome. Alpha is in 11, alpha is in 16, and beta is in 11. حتى تحفظوا واحد كذا زين, okay. طيب, so what is the problem? The problem that they have to be produced in equal quantity. Okay, واضح? يعني لازم alpha وبيتا يكونوا متساوين, they are equal, okay? If alpha is less, it's called alpha thalassemia. If beta is less, It's called beta thalassemia. واضح؟ طيب. The third point is the enzymes. وخبرتكم عن ال G6PD. Okay. احنا قلنا اليوم ما نتحدث كثير عن ال enzyme. وهذا ال this is the issue that I just told you that these are two of alpha and two of beta. So two of alpha and two of beta. Okay. Normal hemoglobin in the adult كيف انت يا عمر اوكي normal hemoglobin in the adult it's called A or adult hemoglobin and it has two as I said to you two alpha and two beta in the there is a small amount of F which has two alpha and two gamma Okay, and then there is an A2, which has two alpha and two delta. These are small amounts. I will talk about that a little bit in details in a minute. Okay, but inside in vitro, in the babies, beta is not contributing significantly. Beta start after birth. Okay, so there is alpha دائما موجود. Alpha is there always there. Okay, but there is also this, which is gamma. Okay, so there is alpha and gamma. So the predominant hemoglobin inside in the baby is fetal. Okay, and small amount of fetal hemoglobin, which is epsilon and zeta. Okay, but and a small amount of course of A, but very little quantity. And you could see that the A start to rise after birth. Okay, so adult hemoglobin is established at the age of 6 months. هنا. See, at the age of 6 months roughly, the hemoglobin F goes down, and normal quantities of alpha and beta are established. That is important because sickle and thalassemia manifestations do not usually appear in neonate. Okay, they appear after 6 months. Okay, now 6 months. The mother may complain to you that the baby is having hand swollen, okay? And that may be the first sign of thalassemia, of a sickle cell, okay? Where you get what we call hand-foot syndrome, okay? So usually it present in that at that age. I told you already that the fetal is hemoglobin F and some hemoglobin A a small amount of hemoglobin A, but mostly hemoglobin F. And then when the adult is established after 6 months, these are what we expect, that A will be the predominant, and then you have A2 and F. And I told you already that A and it's alike, and I'm sure somebody will do the genetics of hemoglobinopathy, and alpha and the alike, and beta and the alike are in the chromosome 16 and 11 respectively. So chain beta is in chromosome 11, chain alpha is in chromosome 16. أو احفظوه إن alpha and beta واحد يعني the alpha is first, it's higher. It's the opposite, okay? And of course, you need to form normal hemoglobin. You need to form alpha and beta, two of alpha and two of beta. Now, why hemoglobinopathies are so common? They are very common. They are by far one of the commonest genetic disorders worldwide, okay? Why they are so common? Because of this possibly natural selection for the protection against severe malaria. هذا ينطبق almost for all of them, but predominantly for sickle, but also for thalassemia, and also for G6PD, okay? And that is why, because sickle cell trait is protective against malaria, and so more and more sickle cell trait are living, and the sickle cell disease, of course, are dying, but more and more sickle cell trait are living, and so they get married. And when sickle cell trait marry to another sickle cell trait, and you produce sickle cell disease, okay? And so on and so forth. Now, second is the consanguinity, and maybe this is for applicable to us, we can discuss. And the third, that as the public nutrition improves, so nutritional diseases and infectious diseases are declining, okay? And عندنا صور طبعا من عمان ومن غير عمان إن الملاريا, for example, has disappeared totally من عمان من ال indigenous population. وكذلك الآن malnutrition is going down or gone down completely, okay? وبالتالي other diseases, hereditary diseases, will become more important. واضح؟ And the last one is the founder effect. يعني somebody like living in يمكن خالصة ولا دكتور بعدين خبركم عن founder effect. إنه if you are living in in a place, isolated place, for example, like in an island, one gene get amplified, and that's what happens in some of these diseases. So thalassemia, it's called anemia of al-Bahr al-Mutawassit, Mediterranean anemia. Okay, it's predominantly around the Mediterranean, so that's the thalassemia. But there is a belt, there is what we call the thalassemia belt, okay, that goes from the Mediterranean across the Arabian Peninsula to India. And here, for example, quite frequent alpha thalassemia and its manifestation. Okay, so this is thalassemia. Okay, and then you look at sickle cell disease is predominantly in Africa, but it has also places in Saudi, in Somalia, in Yemen, in Saudi. And there is a special type in Saudi Arabia, Eastern Saudi Arabia, called the Arab Indian, which is found here and found also in India, plus Oman and the Emirates. So this is sickle cell. Then C is predominantly in Africa, an African disease. And C, we have some C in Oman, particularly في الشرقية. من الشرقية أنت؟ اوكي سمد الشان ووادي الطائيين هذيك المناطق اعتقد في شويه بوكيتس عائلات من اس من 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 سي سو اس سي و اند ذن دي از انذر نيم فور ات از دي بونجاب اند دي بونجاب هنا في الانديان سب كونتيننت و بيكوز اوف اور لينك تو بون تو باكستان اند ذس اند جوادر اند اول ذس اند ترافل اند ذيس There is D is the third commonest genotype that we have. So the common first common is SS. The second commonest is S beta. Third commonest is SD. Okay. So SD is very important, and it's quite severe disease. They get stroke, they get acute chest, and all those sort of thing. Okay. So this is SD called D Bonjab. Mutation is 128-16 to whatever arginine, I think. But you don't worry, you will do it in the molecular. Okay? So this is D. Now, E is found in Southeast Asia, but we have some E also. We have an E family, big E family in Nizwa. Farq bil-Ahra, and we have studied them and we have reported them, but there are some E's from other places as well, and E can combine with S and it can combine with beta thalassemia. Okay, and so you get a beta gives you a thalassemia intermedia, and SE tend to be mild disease. Okay, واضح. طيب, this is the pattern. Now, how common they are worldwide? I told you they are one of the most commonest. 55% of the world population carry alpha thalassemia. 5%, okay? 50 million are carrier for sickle cell gene. 500 million are carrier for sickle cell gene. And we think between 300 to 400,000 patients are born with sickle cell disease every year. Okay, now the problem with sickle is that the vast majority are born in Africa, and so we don't know exact. So that number may be higher, or it may be less, or maybe this, okay? But these are estimate, because the vast majority of these are born in places of low income countries, and the statistics are not accurate. And 90% occur, as I told you, in low Africa. Like, for example, the carrier rate for sickle in Nigeria is, 24%, I was told. Other places maybe up to 50%. So it is a very, and Nigeria has about, it's reaching the population of the United States, I think. So these are the statistics from the WHO by Wetherill, where beta thalassemia is, let me tell you a little bit that beta thalassemia on average is about 1/10 of sickle. So sickle is about 10%, 10 times more than, in general, 10 times more than thalassemia. So beta is 22,000, E-beta is 19,000, 20,000. And then you have sickle, 217, and S-beta, 100. So generally about 290, roughly. طيب, what about Oman? So that was the situation in the world. What about Oman? So Oman, from the study that we have done on alpha, we think that about 48% of you have alpha gene, okay? Which is about 50%, يعني. I'll come to alpha in a minute in detail. Then we have about 5.76% sickle gene, okay? 5.7 sickle gene. Beta thalassemia is about 2%, 2.6. And hemoglobin E and hemoglobin D and hemoglobin C in 1%. So in total, 10% of you will have beta abnormality, okay? Now, out of those, some of you will have beta and alpha. It's okay, it doesn't matter. But beta gene abnormalities are the most serious, and they are accounting for about 10%, okay? Now, sickle cell disease is about 0.3%. So we expect between maybe 120 to 170 sickle patients are born in Oman every year. And about 10 to 15 beta thalassemia major are born in Oman every year. واضح؟ Like for example, unfortunately still we see some beta thalassemia major from Sahar. From Sahar region, from Batna region. Sahar and Muscat are the commonest for thalassemia. Okay?
In Sahar, I think total patient 400.
Sickle, aywa. Bismillah. So this is our estimate that the cost for looking after a sick, so we have 300. I told you there are 300,000 patients born every year, and about 56,000 of thalassemia. Now the cost for looking after each patient is about 7,000 for U.S. dollars, and about 6,600 estimate for U.S. dollars sickle. And if we think that we have 0.08 of thalassemia and 0.3 of sickle, then we get between 120 and 170 sickle and 10 to 15 thalassemia. And so in total, we think that we have about 2,000 patients and 6,000 patients of sickle cell disease. And they cost us 14 million to look after thalassemia and 49 million or 50 million to look after sickle. These are estimates. And, so wait, I don't know. It might be more because these sickle come quite frequently to hospital. They get admitted and they get care and they go to ICU and they get acute chest syndrome. And so, and these other patients get transfused every month and they get chelation therapy. And the chelation therapy is very expensive. 10% of our pharmacy budget goes to exegete. Okay, so it is expensive. So this is the work that we have done where we looked actually at about 8,000 newborn from Sohar and University. And we find, I told you already, that what we did in the cord blood and with the help of Dr. Ali Al-Madhani. Actually, Ali Al-Madhani worked very well with us. He was sending sample from Sohar on every second day from the cord blood. And we collected from we have been doing screening for newborn at the university for the last 15 years, okay? So we have a cumulative data of the newborn in university, but unfortunately not in the rest of Oman. So we did a project with Dr. Ali Al-Madhani where we looked at Sohar and university. We did a CBC, and then everybody got a CBC. Every born in Oman, in university get a CBC and the cord blood. And then he gets a HBLC. Okay, and why we do the HBLC at birth? Because that is the only time when we can make a diagnosis of alpha. واضح? Alpha thalassemia cannot be diagnosed by HBLC except at birth. Okay, هذه معلومة مهمة. Okay, and it gets diagnosed because we use HBLC and we can find what we call BARTS. I'll tell you a little bit about it. So what we did is we stratify them. If they have positive BARTS, then they have alpha, and they do, that's a group. And if they have negative BARTS, then they don't have alpha, and that's a normal group. Okay? واضح? So HBLC done, then they are separated into two groups. One that has parts and one that does not have parts. If they have parts, hemoglobin parts, then they are alpha. If they don't have hemoglobin parts, then they are normal. Okay? And that's what we find, that how did we also, so we, these are the normal here, okay? And we found that, that is another issue, that what is the limitation of neonatal screening if you do it? The limitation is that you cannot 100% diagnose beta thalassemia trait, okay? 100%, but 99%, okay? So what we did is that we adopted a protocol. We said, in beta thalassemia, what do you expect the beta thalassemia measure? What do you expect the prominent, the dominant hemoglobin to be? F hemoglobin, F, high F, and little A or no B, no A, okay? But what we did is that if we find that A is less than 10%, then we suspect beta thal trait. If we have a hemoglobin, if you have a thalassemia measure, it is clear that you have F and very little A, okay? But if you have less A, less than 10%, and some F, and then you suspect. So that is the group that we suspected, that if it is A less than 10%, in fact, we raised it to 12%, but 10%, then we suspect beta thalassemia. If the hemoglobin A is above 10%, then it is normal. If they have another variant, for example, if they have S, of course, you know that it is S, sickle, either S straight or S disease, you make the diagnosis later, okay? I'll show you now in a minute. And then the other ones, the same also. They have BARTS, so they have alpha. But they also, if they are above 10, then they are normal. If they are below 10, then they are beta thalassemia trait, beta plus alpha. And if they have other variants, like S and D and others, okay? Yeah, so this is a three. I'll show you now. We'll come to the details. Yeah, so that is what I just told you, that the group with the lowest hemoglobin BARTS level are normal. 0.6% to 1.1. These are normal, okay? Then there is one that they have what we call alpha plus thalassemia trait, alpha thalassemia, their level is up to 2%. I'll show you details now, Kevin, then the thalassemia alpha is complicated, okay? Then you have a third group where you actually have maybe a combination of alpha naught plus alpha plus, and their BARTS level is up to 9%. And then you have another group which you have no deletional and non-deletional, and their BARTS is up to 7%. Okay, I'll show you this. This sounds a little bit complicated. I'll show you in details in a minute. So how did we, also how does it differ? These are the neonatal groups that we find, and that their hemoglobin at birth, if they are normal, is 15. Here is there is a mistake, it's 14. So they are, if they are alpha, they are less, a little bit less low hemoglobin if they are at birth. If they are normal, their hemoglobin is higher. You know, neonates have a high hemoglobin. Yes, this is your territory. The other is the red cell is higher in alpha thalassemia, in patients with alpha thalassemia, because they compensate by producing more red cells. Okay, if you compare it to normal, the most determinant is the MCV. What happens in general if you have alpha, if you have thalassemia? The red cells is smaller than their size. Okay? هذا معلومة أخرى أيضا. The red cell is smaller in their size in thalassemia, whether it's beta or alpha. Okay? Microcytic, microcytosis. Yes. Okay, so the MCV normal is higher, much higher, and we said this is the most discriminating, It's about 10 femtoliters lower in patient with alpha thalassemia. Okay, so if you look at the newborn CBC, the most important to tell you whether there is alpha or not is the MCV. Okay, the MCV will be lower in patient with alpha or thalassemia in general than the normal. Now, this is just summarize of what I just told you already. تعرف study done by the Minister of Health أنا رجب إيش دخلت فيه وشهينة دار دكتورة زكية وحد مجموعة من ال Minister of Health in 1995 تذكر الدكتور مسلم. And at that time S is 5.7% and beta thal was 2.16. Okay, a study that we have done beta thal is a little bit higher, 2.62. And ما I'm not sure. I'm not worried too much. It's probably the same. لكن لأن إحنا we have taken Suhar and Suhar ومسقط are the areas for thalassemia. So maybe the area is a little bit higher. But S in combination it comes to the same. What we have learned new, which was not done in the Ministry of Health study, is this alpha. So alpha is about 48% in the population. واضح؟ طيب. Now, why we have this problem with hemoglobinopathy? One of them is the consanguinity. A study done by Anna Rajab in 2010 showed that 56% of the Omani people marry within the extended family, okay, within the third or maybe the fourth generation relatives, okay? Now, the other is why we have all this hemoglobinopathy is that we have been linking with the many countries around us, travel to Iraq, travel to India, travel to Africa, travel to all those sort of places, and so we brought all of these genes. And they migrated. Maybe they migrated through these routes, or maybe migrated through other routes as well. Maya. Now we do a little bit alpha and how. So I told you alpha is complicated. There are four genes that control alpha, okay? Now, and we know that three genes are enough to maintain normal. If there is one gene, شوفوا لاحظوا. هيوة. أنا بخبركم أيضا. This is alpha 1 and alpha 2. Alpha 1, alpha 2. Okay? Okay? Now, if one of them is missing, it's called silent carrier, usually absolutely asymptomatic, okay? No symptoms, and the hemoglobin is very good. If they have two, then depending on where they missed it. So if there's alpha thal 1, which they are lost alpha 1 and alpha 2 in the same size, okay? Here, معايا انتو? هنا. Alpha 1 and alpha 2 missed on the same side, and these patients will have mild microcytosis. Or they have this is called the Asian or the cis, okay? Now, the second one is where they have a homologous shabihat. So alpha 1, alpha 1, but beta, alpha 2 and alpha 2 are missing, and this is what we call the African type, okay? Now, we think that probably we have a little bit more trans and less cis, that is why we don't see that we don't see. Now, hemoglobin parts and hemoglobin H. Now, hemoglobin H is three missing, okay? لاحظوا, 1, 2, 3, okay? And usually it's replaced by these hemoglobin bars or tetramic gamma. So inside the baby, there is alpha and gamma. And so alpha is missing, it's replaced by gamma, okay? And the four is where we don't, thank God, we don't see a lot of it. So is the hydrops fetalis, okay? Which is usually is either die inside the mother in utero or immediately, shortly after birth. واضح, these are the concepts that I want you to take first, so then we don't move except if you have, if you understood this.
هايو. Three
to be H parts
and four hydroxylates.
هايو. بس أنت شجاعة لأنك قلت deletion, بس هم طبعا ما كلهم deletions. They could be non-deletional, should be deletional, non-deletional. طبعا بعدين عاد دكتور وخالصة بيخبروكم عن كل هذا. زين هذا نفس الدايجرامز اللي قلت لكم عليه الآن. Now, what did we do with our university with that study? Is we do an alpha gene scan and we look at the alpha gene only show you a peak. It does not tell you what is the exact abnormality. It's a quantitative assay using PCR. So it amplify the alpha, alpha one and alpha two, and you look at the peaks. And if they are matching the control, then you know they are normal. If they are shorter or absent, then you know that they are absent. واضح؟ I'll show you now in diagrammatic fashion. So we define them. If they are deleted, يعني معناهم ما موجودين. So they are either will be shorter because there is less quantity or absent because they are not there at all. If they are not reduced in their quantity, then we call this is a non-deletional and we do a different program for them. These ones tend to be the more complex. They are the least common, but they are the more complex. This is more common, less complex. This is more less common, more complex. واضح؟ طبعا إيش, what did we do? We do this RNAs, P is as the reference or as the control. And you can see alpha 1 and alpha 2, two peaks nicely. خبرتكم into alpha 1, alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 2. And they are nice peaks, okay? Now, if this is alpha 1 and alpha 1, so alpha 1 is present. But alpha 2 not present, so it is missing. واضح? Now, alpha 1 and alpha 1, the same quantity. Alpha 2 and alpha 2 missing, so shorter. واضح? This is the gene scan. Very good, very rapid. 4 hours, خلصت الأسي. Okay? خالصة بعدين عادة أتنازعني في هذا الموضوع. Now, هذا نفس الكلام قلت لكم عنه. إنه هنا this is an additional. هو هذا احنا اخبرنا هذا انه there is alpha 1 normal, alpha 2 1, so this is shorter, this is normal, this is alpha 1 normal, alpha 1 but missing alpha 2. This is, look at this one, nice. Alpha 1 ما في alpha 1, so shorter. Alpha 2 ما في alpha 2, so there is shorter, so short both. Okay, واضح. And this one, what's happening here? Alpha 1, alpha 2, which additional, طلع فوق. Okay, واضح. So this is gene scan. Okay, now it is a complicated, alpha is a complicated process, but what do you see in the alpha? You see it running in the fast region of HBLC. Okay, so this is hemoglobin bar. So this patient has alpha, and the A2 here is very low, and that's defined. One of the features of alpha. And we do an HBRB, and this is what happened. These are the gamma tetramers precipitating. I have already mentioned some of these are there, two highly homologous alpha 2 and alpha 1 in cis encode identical alpha globin polypeptide chain. Alpha 2 is transcribed at a higher level, ما نعرف ليش, and that makes the complication. So 2.6 folds higher than alpha 1. Alpha thalassemia are commonly due to deletion, خبرتكم بهذا, but some of them are also non-deletional. Okay, two types of single gene deletion and multiple types of double gene deletion form. I'll show you now. Impact of the mutation affecting the alpha 2 is more severe. Alpha 2 mutations are more severe. So alpha 2 is prescribed more. Alpha 2 mutations are more severe. And deletional is less severe. Non-deletional are more severe. أعتقد لو عرفته هل الثلاثة والأربع معلومات كافية عن الألفاء. طيب. صلى الله عليه وسلم. So what we found in Oman is deletional alpha plus هذا 3.7 and 4.2. These are base pair. And deletional alpha 0 is this MED mutation. And then the non-deletional we have this polyadenylation signal, which what we call alpha T Saudi, described first in Saudi Arabia, but فأنت بس عشان شوية توسعوا دماغكم. وtermination codon, what we call hemoglobin constant spring. Alpha T Saudi tend, if it comes, it tends to be complicated and you get hemoglobin H. Okay. And I told you already what happened is that this, you get a peak in the fast moving area of the hemoglobin in HBLC, similarly. And sometimes you get a shoulder, what we call shouldering. These are what we call hemoglobin variants. بعدين بعرويكم تفاصيل زيادة شوية. We looked at the hemoglobin H and as deletional and non-deletional, and the most cases are non-deletional, but some are deletional. And if you look at, if you look at their hemoglobin, if this is a 3.7 and I met this is a deletional, so their hemoglobin is a little bit higher. This is 3.7 deletional, so hemoglobin is higher. But this is a alpha T Saudi, so their hemoglobin is, this is a non-deletional, so their hemoglobin is lower. Okay? They tend to be a little bit more complicated. If you want, you could look at our paper in the European Journal of Hematology in details. Sometimes also see the mother has a non-deletional, a deletional, which is hemoglobin is very nice, but here a non-deletional hemoglobin is low. And similarly for the children that had non-deletional, you could see that their hemoglobin is lower than their other siblings. Now, sometimes also alpha comes with S. And when alpha comes with S, the hemoglobin S go down. Okay? So here is a patient who has a hemoglobin S of only 18%. What would you call that?
Less than 40, a trait.
So this is a sickle cell trait, but has low MCV. So it has a hemoglobin H plus sickle cell trait. Yes. So this patient has a hemoglobin H and sickle. Okay. Now, what does alpha? So why we are interested now in alpha? Because alpha thalassemia, when I say alpha, I mean alpha thalassemia. So because we are talking about alpha thalassemia today, because alpha affects on sickle and also affect on beta. Okay, because لاحظوا مثلا على سبيل المثال انتم 50% منكم 50% of you have alpha 100% واحد منكم بيكون انا لما رحت الى ايرلندا ذبحوني يعني they drove me crazy because I am in first year medicine and they told me oh your MCV is low. I said, what is that? Am I having HIV or this or that? Or يعني, I don't know. وبعدين أروح at night, I am reading the books. What is thalassemia? And only the first year medicine, I'm doing physics and chemistry and I don't know. And not only that, but they said, we don't have the test here. We have to send it to the UK. So I said, God, this is... So this is it can cause trouble. Okay. So what does alpha thalassemia do to sickle cell? It makes the red cell smaller. خبرتكم إنه it makes the red cell smaller. And when they are smaller, their MCH's content is lower. Their fewer dense dehydrated cell, irreversibly sickled are less. These patients get less stroke. So patient with alpha thalassemia and sickle have less stroke because the cells are smaller, but they have unfortunately more avascular necrosis of the hip, and we don't really understand why. Okay? يعني maybe because the red cells are more stiff or whatever, I don't know. Now alpha thalassemia in general in Oman is not very serious, but this is a data from Thailand. I told you alpha thalassemia is a problem in Southeast Asia. This is Thailand, this is from Professor Phib, and it varies from even thalassemia, it can become like a thalassemia major, or I told you hydrop fatalis, so it varies. But in Oman, we don't see much of hemoglobin H, and we don't see problems with alpha thalassemia. The reason for that is that probably we have more trans rather than cis. Maybe. So I told you already about hemoglobin H, and the hemoglobin H is three gene deletion or three gene abnormality, and it's a variable hemoglobin and usually have splenomegaly. These patients will have splenomegaly. The only problems that it occurs is during pregnancy. They may require blood transfusion. They may require blood transfusion. But in general, they are asymptomatic. But it is not very common also. طيب. What about beta? So احنا سوينا شوية concept about alpha. قلت لكم إن there are four genes. And what happens if there is one gene abnormality? It's a silent. If it is two genes, it's a thalassemia minor. If it is, and it is whether it's alpha 1 or alpha or thalassemia 1 or thalassemia 2, depending on whether it's the cis or trans. And then the third one is hemoglobin H, three genes. And the fourth one is hemoglobin BARS or hydrops fatalis, where there are four genes deleted. طيب. Now, what about beta? Beta is also a little bit diverse, although I think thalassemia in general is a little bit more homogeneous than sickle cell. But it's also, and it fair, it has, there are three forms for beta thalassemia. Now here, احنا قلنا if there is a loss of alpha, it's alpha. If there is a loss of beta, it's beta, okay? Now luckily, two genes are controlling beta, okay? So one gene from the father, one gene from the mother. These are all recessive disorders, okay? And they are divided into three groups, a major, intermediate, and a trait.
Sorry, that means alpha thalassemia dominant?
No, recessive.
Recessive.
Recessive. طيب, احنا التريت, usually thalassemia trait, the only thing that you find is that the patient will have a low MCV, okay, and a high red cells, okay? I'll show you now examples in a minute. And hemoglobin A2 will be elevated, okay? Hemoglobin A2, A2 is what? Is an alpha and delta. Because beta is not there, alpha is combining with delta, okay, in the trait. Now there are a number of mutations that we know about beta thalassemia in Oman, and they all came from different region. And that's again, the problematic of our link. So for example, the IPS, which is the commonest mutation, has come from the Indian subcontinent, okay? 25th base pair deletion comes from Iran. Codon 14 is the commonest in Iraq. And hemoglobin Dhofar is a combination of a Mediterranean mutation and an African mutation. So you could see that our link with the rest of the world has brought all of these mutations. And للأسف اليوم الانيميشن is not going to work with me. I tried before I came, but anyway, we'll skip it. لاحظة في الـ HBLC, and I did not explain it early, but here what usually appears is the alpha abnormality. If there is an alpha, for example, hemoglobin BARTS, here is the hemoglobin F. Okay, here is hemoglobin F. Here, these are all glycosylated hemoglobin. Okay, glycosylated hemoglobin. يعني hemoglobin A, but combined with sugar. Okay, and sometimes if you have a diabetic patient, this glycosylated will rise. Okay, so sometimes we'll say to the clinician, please check this patient's sugar because the glycosylated hemoglobin is high. Okay, now the third is hemoglobin A. This is normal hemoglobin. Okay, here should appear what? If there was one, إيش هنا المفروض يكون؟ S. أيوة. So if there was S, it will appear here, and this is A2, okay, or A2. So this patient had a high hemoglobin A2. A2 is 7. Usually the A2 is up to what? 3.5. عظيم. Okay. Now 3.3, 3.4. Think about it. Very important. Don't dismiss it, particularly in a female. In a female, she may be iron deficient. If she has iron deficiency, replace the iron and then check the A2 because you may be missing beta thalassemia. Okay? So A2 is reduced in iron deficiency. Hemoglobin A2 is reduced in iron deficiency. For you who are doing the counseling, very important that you don't dismiss. If the MCV is low and the A2 is 3.3 or 3.4, please, please, please replace the iron and repeat the A2. Yeah, so أنا للأسف اليوم ما قدرت كان عندي cases فعلا يعني كان A2 مثلا 3.2 reported as normal and I was not happy and I gave the replacement of iron and A2 came 3.6, 3.5. So it is important that, but if it came normal then you are okay. It might be alpha, so MCV will go down with alpha. So you have to be careful that you are not missing beta. Well, أنا أقول لك إنه you'll be suspicious. هي وفعلا. Okay. These are the not so clear, but beta thalassemia trait in the peripheral blood. You will see. What do you see in the peripheral blood? Target cells is one of the signs of. So beta thalassemia. I told you already that if it is major, usually these patients require blood transfusion. They will not live without a transfusion. What does it mean, major? Major, that means that they inherited two affected genes from each parent, number one. Number two, there is very little production of A. Okay? So they are producing only F and some A2, okay? And these patients will require blood transfusion, okay, the whole of their life. Or transplant, or bone marrow transplant. Thalassemia intermedia, thalassemia minor, I told you that these patients are normal, asymptomatic, and usually their hemoglobin might be even normal, okay? It might be a little bit low, or it might be normal, even to 12, 13 hemoglobin. But their MCV and their RBC will be low. واضح? And you do a hemoglobin A2, and it will be elevated. But be very careful with the females who are iron deficient, or male who is iron deficient, okay? Because it can reduce the... And then intermedia, we are learning more and more. These patients don't require blood transfusion, but their hemoglobin is 7, 8, 9, maybe 10, and they absorb more iron, and they show thalassemic fascia. But what protected them is that they are producing some normal A, okay? And so that is why they are an intermediate. So depending on the mutation that they had for the beta, they will produce, whether they are producing A or not. طيب. صلى الله عليه وسلم. Target cells, the type of mutation that we see in beta thalassemia, I don't want to spend time, but here is the type of mutation that we see in Oman. So IVS is the commonest, codon 44 is second commonest, and then hemoglobin Dhofar. Hemoglobin Dhofar accounts for about 7% of all thalassemia in Oman, of all beta abnormality in Oman, okay? 7%. Okay, and then the others are in smaller, 25 codon 20, deletion 25 base IVS is the fourth commonest, and so on. The others are rare. These are also, you can refer to them from Dr. Shahina's publication. And I told you where they come from. I have already shown you that the codon 44 comes from Iraq, 20 minus 25 base pair deletion, it's coming from Iran. And then the IVS is predominantly Indian subcontinent, and then hemoglobin Dhofar is a combination on African and a Mediterranean.
Abbreviation, IVS.
Intervening segment.
Deletion.
Intervening segment. Now, this is a patient who has, what does he have? Look at where the beak is. The beak is is in the F region, so it is a very high F, okay, and some A2, but no A, okay, no A, or very little A, less than 1%, okay, and so this patient has high hemoglobin F, small amount of A2, no A, huh? This is a thalassemia major, okay? He's not producing, he's producing, combining alpha with gamma, okay? So he's producing F. ليش نقول هي دائما احنا هذا 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 عنصرية hemoglobin 6. And this is the peripheral blood of this patient, so they will have what we call, what is this? This one. كيف المورفولوجي عندكم؟ Nucleated RBC. So these patients will release cells which have nucleus still because the bone marrow is starting to compensate and there are some target cells. تعرفوا التارجت؟ hemoglobinized, Balor hemoglobinization. Usually the red cell has a hemoglobinized area and a Balor in the middle. But هنا زيادة الهيموغلوبينيزيشن اوكي سو ذس از كولد تارجت تعرفوا التارجت هذا الشركه مال الهدف ايوه ما شركه اسمها تارجت اوكي اخاف انكم تناموا انت في فلذلك ذس از ا بيشنت هو هاز ا بيتا ثلاسيميا ميجر يو كان سي ذا فرونتال بولسينج ذا فلاتنينج اوف ذا نيزل اند ذن ذا ماكسيلاري برومينانس and the hair, see the hair is up. Okay, these are classical for beta thalassemia. What hopes in احنا, we don't see these images now anymore in Oman because the care, when you transfuse this patient, some of them actually you are not able to see that they have thalassemia because they are well transfused. Why you get these changes? Because you get expansion of the bone marrow cavity in areas where the bone marrow is produced. And when you suppress it with a blood transfusion, that expansion does not occur, okay? And they get, of course, big liver, okay? Big liver. But hopefully we will not see this now. And the child will be reduced in height. So this is the father and this is the patient. So what happened, what is the pathophysiology of beta thalassemia? A little bit about beta thalassemia, because I wasn't sure what I should do, so I said, so you have, I told you that you have excess alpha, because there is no beta, okay? And with excess alpha, there is a reduction, of course, the reduced beta or absent beta, okay? And with absent beta, you get membrane damage, peripheral blood, you get hemolysis, you get anemia, and similarly, precipitation. If there is absent beta, you get precipitation in the bone marrow, premature death, ineffective hematopoiesis. يعني بمعنى إن the red cells are produced in the bone marrow, but they die. They die in the bone marrow. They are not coming into the circulation. Why? Because they don't have beta, they have only alpha. واضح? And so they have anemia. Because they have anemia, the body senses that there is anemia, so it absorbs more iron. Okay, so it absorbs more iron. Plus the body senses, the kidney senses that there is anemia, so erythropoietin is produced. Plus the bone marrow is expanding because bone marrow is starting to compensate. And skeletal, you get skeletal changes. You need blood transfusion, you get iron overload, you get cardiac. Because why? You get what we call liberation of free radical. Free radical damaged the cardiac, damaged the liver, okay? And that's why you get damage, you get cirrhosis and liver failure and heart failure in these patients with beta thalassemia, okay? There is this thalassemia intermedia now. We are learning more what we call non-transfusion dependent thalassemia. Non-transfusion dependent thalassemia, okay? Well, NTDT, non-transfusion-dependent thalassemia, or thalassemia intermedia, يعني. Okay? These patients, إيش اللي يصير؟ إنه they may inherit one or two mild beta thalassemia gene. okay? Or they have E with beta, with when you have A beta or E with beta, so father gives E and the mother gives beta, okay? Or the axe, all right? Then they get a mild, what we call thalassemia intermediate. Or hemoglobin H sometimes also become like a thalassemia intermediate. It may require blood transfusion, okay? So this is the definition of non-transfusion dependent thalassemia. And it is an intermediate stage between beta thalassemia major and alpha and beta thalassemia minor. So it's في الوسط بين beta thalassemia minor normal and beta thalassemia major transfusion. Okay? Hemoglobin will be around 7 to 10, I told you, without transfusion. More severe red cell abnormality than thalassemia, varying degree of spleen, increased susceptibility to infection, and skeletal changes. And these patients become iron overloaded. Why they become iron overloaded? Because their body sense there is always anemia, so it absorbs more iron. Plus they receive the occasional transfusions, okay? So they become iron overloaded. And so they have skeletal, and their bone marrow cavity is expanded. So comparison between thalassemia major and thalassemia intermediate. Thalassemia major require transfusion, chelation, and so on. Thalassemia intermediate, no transfusion, growth problems, splenomegaly, poor follow-up. That's the problem, that they don't come because they are well. They don't come to the hospital. They are picked by chance, okay? They are reasonably well. They are happy with the hemoglobin of 8, and they are going around their life, but their skeletal changes are there. They get osteoporosis. They have, even they developed the iron overload complications and so on. And so these patients need to be picked up. They get also tendency for thrombosis. We don't really know why, because of intravascular hemolysis, they get thrombosis. So we, yes. Yeah, so. So we follow them up, and almost all of them require chelation therapy, meaning نعطيهم دواء للحديد, okay? Plus also we follow their osteoporosis, we follow that they sometimes have what we call extramedullary hematopoiesis. They start to produce the bone marrow outside the produce cells outside the bone marrow, okay? Like in the spine outside, and so it can cause them pain. So they require intervention like hydroxyurea and maybe radiotherapy and maybe surgery. Okay. Sometimes if they become transfusion dependent, we take their spleen out. They have also even infarction in the brain. Now we have, I told you already, Bri-FIT mutations for Oman. Oman is this hemoglobin ظفار. And hemoglobin ظفار, what we call Bri-FIT mutation. يعني خاصة حال عمان خصوصي. Okay. So we will not give it to Claire. Claire will not take it. And usually it is a double heterozygous. So a thalassemia from Lebanon, codon 29, and an African sickle cell mutation, codon 58. They combine and they represent, they are usually like thalassemia intermedia to a thalassemia major. Many of them require blood transfusion. Okay, so a stage between thalassemia major, thalassemia intermedia to thalassemia major. But many of them require transfusion. We actually have bone marrow transplant for them from ظفار. Okay. هذا البيبر طبعا انتو الريفرنس بتاعها موجود هنا. دكتورة شاهينة and hemoglobin ظفار and unique to Oman of severe thalassemia intermedia, so it's a stage a little bit close to thalassemia major. Okay, usually hemoglobin over 8 and severe thalassemic fascia recommend patient with ظفار to receive blood transfusion as soon as they are diagnosed. Okay. And it took its name from where it was discovered first, yes. Now, if there is delta thalassemia, we are now interested a little bit in delta because the A2 is a little bit low, but it's not usually causing any problem, okay? But it causes problem because it reduces the A2, and you can miss beta thalassemia, okay? You can miss beta thalassemia trait. So it's very important. So if we have a microcytosis and we are suspecting that it is thalassemia, we'll do beta and we will do alpha. And if we have excluded all of these, then we may look for the common mutations in delta, okay? I don't want you to worry too much about it, okay? And these are what we did, about 40 samples with low hemoglobin A2. What do we mean by low hemoglobin A2? Hemoglobin A2 below 2%, okay? 1.9, 1.8, 1.5, that sort of level. We separated it aside and we looked for delta. There is a paper that we have published on delta. Now, I'll talk a little bit about my favorite disease, and that is sickle cell. But I spend a lot of time looking after patients with sickle. So Ankum, do you have any questions on thalassemia first before we move? Now, sickle is not a new disease. It was described first time in 1910 by a person called Herrick. And this Jamaican person, Graham Sargent, has described or written on the 100 years of sickle cell disease in 2010. But we know maybe Tutankhamun maybe had a sickle cell disease. Okay, so it's an old disease. Tutankhamun, المصريين معانا في كل شيء. طيب. But this is what he saw, this Herrick, in 1910, in a Jamaican student who was studying in the United States. Okay, Jamaica, تعرفوا فين جامايكا؟ جامايكا is in البحر الكاريبي. Okay, أمريكا الوسطى. Okay, and he moved to the United States to study medicine. Okay, and he became sick. And he looked at his peripheral blood and he find that they have these irreversibly sickle. So this is the first description of sickle cell disease. Okay, now, زين إنه, so this is normal. Okay, تنفسوا شوية. Okay. This is normal, and you see a hemoglobinized and a pallor. Nice, okay? This is sickle cell disease. I'll show you target قبل, يعني يمكن هذه, شوفوا, hemoglobinized, pallor, بعدين hemoglobinized مرة, it's to call target. But this is sickle, this is called irreversibly sickled. This cell will never go back to normal, okay? This is called pseudo-sickled, a boat-shaped, pseudo-كاذبه, okay? It may become oxygenated and it go back to normal, but usually it does. It will go back to irreversibly sickled, okay? So this is a sickle cell, normal and irreversibly sickled. What is the problem with sickle cell?
We talked this morning about it.
So the problem with sickle is that you have a mutation in the beta chain, okay? And that mutation, only one amino acid change, okay? One amino acid change from glutamic acid to valine. So this is normal hemoglobin. You see glutamic acid in the beta chain, and it is replaced by valine, okay? So glutamic acid replaced by valine. Glutamic acid is negatively charged, valine has no charge. Okay, and so the molecule, hemoglobin molecule, become positively charged. Okay? الشحنة بتاعته. Now, this I want to spend a little bit time on this picture because imagine you have a red cell. What is inside that red cell? Hemoglobin. Hemoglobin, okay? It has a 2 alpha and the 2 beta. And what does it do? It carry oxygen, okay? Now, when it deliver oxygen, the hemoglobin, when it deliver oxygen in sickle cell, when it deliver oxygen to the cells, it forms knobs, يعني خنعة, okay? It form خنعة هنا, okay? That allow other hemoglobin molecule to come together and form a thread. لحظة مش الريد سيل احنا بعد نتحدث, نتحدث عن الهيموغلوبين انسايد ذا ريد سيل. اوكي سو ذا هيموغلوبين فورم ثريد 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 اند ات فورمز ثريد لايك ذس ذات بريسيبيتيت انسايد ذا ريد سيل. And when it precipitates inside the red cell, it changes from biconcave like this to irreversibly sickled. Okay? واضح هذا الكونسبت؟ So, red cell, inside it is hemoglobin. It has two alpha, two beta. It carry oxygen. When it deliver the oxygen, it become, it form knobs or خنعة. It attach itself to another hemoglobin molecule. It precipitate inside the red cell and it pull the membrane of the red cell. And it become by it become sickled. واضح؟ طيب. What happened to it when the red cell become sickled? It become leaky. So water comes out of the cell and it become dehydrated. And more precipitation of the hemoglobin inside the red cell. Okay? That is why we tell patient not to become dehydrated, because there are some, and plus also, when the red cell change its shape, it become sharp, and when it become sharp, it burst, تطعن, it burst أو تخرق, الفسلز, and the vessel you get proliferation of the intima, الفسل داخل, it become narrow. And you get intimal proliferation and narrow. When it becomes narrow, it can get occluded more easily. واضح؟ طيب. Now, so as it plus also, as the red cell passes, it activates the platelets. And the يعني لاحظوا أنتوا إنه عندنا this is the blood vessel here. What does it have? Have blood in it. What is that blood? It contains. It contains the red cell. It contains the platelets. It contains the white cells. And so as they are passing through this vessel, it activates the platelets. And when it activates the platelets, it releases material like thrombosbundin, which is a very sticky. It allows the red cell to stick more. That is why the vessel that are narrow, like in the hip or in the brain, get occluded rapidly. واضح؟ So this is a summary of our sickle. It's one of my nicest. I like this this diagram. So you have a hemoglobin. It's a. يعني I want to show you why, for example, somebody who has sickle within the same family, and one patient is mild, the other one is more severe, and the other third one is more severe. We don't really understand. So. A sickle is a very heterogeneous disease, okay? حتى داخل نفس العائلة, it varies. Now, so what happens at when it becomes deoxygenated? You get intracellular polymerization, formation of polymer. خبرتكم عنه, okay? Formation of polymer, then the membrane become deformed. And when the membrane become deformed, the membrane damage. And when the membrane damage, hemolysis. When hemolysis, you get anemia. When anemia, the reticulocyte will increase. Reticulocyte are sticky. Reticulocyte are the immature red cells, okay? And they are sticky into the membrane, and so it get occlusion, you get adhesion, endothelial adhesion, and you get VOC. The whole manifestation or the whole mark of sickle cell is VOC, or vaso-occlusive process, okay? Vaso-occlusive process. Everything about sickle is vaso-occlusion, okay? Whether it's in brain, whether it's in the lung, whether it's in the spleen, whether it's in the kidney, in the liver, and so on, okay? So VOC, and you get acute chest syndrome, you get bony pain, you get hand-foot syndrome, you get splenic sequestration, you get leg ulcer, you get bribism, and so on and so forth. واضح؟ طيب. This picture واضحة؟ So what did we do? We use a drug called hydroxyurea. Hydroxyurea reduces the white cell and so reduces the adhesion, plus increase the hemoglobin F. And when your hemoglobin F is increased, less sickling. Aywa. Very important. شوفوا, لاحظوا, inside the red cell, there are different hemoglobins. The higher the hemoglobin F, the better is the disease because less sickling. واضح? Inside the red cell. So this is a diagrammatic. Is that you have a precipitation of the reticulocyte, then you get a vaso occlusion, and eventually it occluded. Okay, so hemolysis, reticulocyte precipitate, then you get other cells coming around it, and then it occluded. Okay, واضح ولا أنت you are okay؟ طيب هذه نزوة لازم يعني أعتمد أيها. There are two modules for sickle cell disease. Okay, there is the hemolytic module and the white cell or cytokine module. Okay, the hemolytic module is where you get hemolysis, and with hemolysis you get liberation of hemoglobin. Red cell broken in the vessel, you get liberation of free hemoglobin. Free hemoglobin reduce nitric oxide. Nitric oxide is a vasodilator. And when you reduce nitric oxide, you get vasoconstriction. Okay? So, ما بغى complicate the issue for you. Red cell broken, liberation of hemoglobin, reduce nitric oxide, vasoconstriction. Okay? And you get pulmonary hypertension, bribism, stroke, and so on. Or you get this activation of the white cells. And with the activation of the white cell, you get cytokine release. And cytokine, like some of them are vasoconstrictors, and some of them are vasodilators, and so on. And you get painful cries, acute chest, and osteonecrosis, okay, of VOSU. Hallel modules, this is conceptual modules. To come back to sickle shwaya Oman, so sickle Oman is thalassemia. I told you that it is commoner, thalassemia is commoner in Batina and Muscat, and sickle is commoner in Sharqiyya and Dakhliyya. Okay, so sickle, Sharqiyya and Dakhliyya, and like for example, look at Nizwa. Dakhliya, يمكن up to 10% carrier rate, but in Nizwa, for example, maybe up to 13% carrier rate in Nizwa, which is very bad. يعني, okay, whereas thalassemia is less common, and it is mostly in Batina and Muscat. And I showed you already this, and I showed you this already, that these are the sickle cell. What is this? ما حد عندكم تكنولوجيست هنا ولا؟ لا. This is the sickling test. So the sickling test is a rapid test. It detects sickling test if there is S or not. So if you can see through it, it's normal. This is positive. Okay, so this is sickle positive. This is sickle normal. Okay, now it does not differentiate between sickle cell disease and sickle cell trait. It just detects whether there is S or not. واضح? Very important. ليش? لأن في البريفري يسيوا لهم سيكلينج وبعدين ما يكملوا البروسيس. Okay? Which is absolutely wrong. Okay? You have to do everything correctly. Now, diagnosis of sickle is dependent on the presence of S. If the S is less than 45%, it's sickle cell trait. If the S is above 65%, is sickle cell disease. واضح? Above, less than 45, is sickle cell trait. More than 65, sickle cell disease. Okay. Question. What happened in the one in between?
40. Huh? To ask. 45 to
65. Secret. بنخبرك تولان بعد شوية. لكن usually, you don't see. Okay? It's either less than 45 is sickle, unless the patient is transfused. If the patient is transfused, S will go down. But if the patient is not transfused, if it is above 45, if it's above 65, it's sickle cell disease. Below 45 is sickle cell trait. طيب, we'll see now in a minute, okay? So, هنا F, وهنا A, وهنا A2, وهنا S. Sorry, أنا يمكن قلت لكم S, A2, A, F. So the patient has A and S. There is A and there is S. So patient is trait, sickle cell trait. Well, S هنا is 26%. Okay, واضح. Now, 26% هيو less than 45 but 26% usually is seen in patient who have alpha thalassemia. So this patient will have alpha thalassemia plus sickle cell trait. If the patient has 33, 34, 35, 40, then it is without alpha thalassemia. Okay. دائما انظروا, look for the clues. CBC and HBLC, look for the clue. And I spend a lot of time في النزوة لما العيادة to train the doctor who is there, so that they look for clues. You can learn a lot from the CBC, learn a lot from the HBLC. If the MCV is low and the patient has MCV and the patient has no beta thalassemia, then you suspect alpha. And this patient probably has alpha thalassemia, okay? Lakin we cannot see it as an adult. We cannot confirm it except by molecular. Now, there is one thing. لاحظوا إنه الـ A2 قريب من الـ S. Okay؟ واضح؟ الـ A2 قريب من الـ S. Okay؟ And some of AS migrate with A2. And so in the presence of S, A2 in HBLC is not accurate. Okay? كيف حالك عفاف؟ واضح؟ ايوه. طيب. When تعرفوا ال HBLC, in HBLC we according to electrical charge and it runs in columns, okay? So there is column for A, there is column for F, there is column for S, there is column for A2, and so on. واضح؟ Now if S is running beside A2, واضح؟ هذه النقطة الأولى. هذا S وهذا A2, okay? So some of S migrate with A2. لذلك أنتوا تشوفوا هنا الـ A2 is 5.3, you will say beta thalassemia. But this patient not beta thalassemia, does not have beta, because some of S is migrating with the A2. واضح؟ So, أعيد لكم إياها مرة أخرى statement. A2 in the presence of S is not reliable because it's not so accurate. In HBLC, in... أيوة بتجيلك لأن عندي كيسز الآن بنجيلها. هذه خبيرة المختبرات. طيب يلا. So the father hemoglobin A 59, hemoglobin S 33, hemoglobin A 2, hemoglobin F 1%. Diagnosis of father? Huh? Sickle cell trait. عظيم. عظيم. Mother? Hemoglobin A 85. Hemoglobin A 2 4. Hemoglobin F 2.2. Diagnosis of mother? Huh? Huh? لا لا. ركزي ركزي. F شوية على على أيوة. والـ A2 ها
F والـ
A2 ها بيتا ثال تريت بيتا ثال تريت. فإيش تتوقعوا إحنا الآن؟ I will use the الآن I will use the so لا دقيقة واحدة دقيقة واحدة. فاعطوني ال the father. What is the combination of the father? ها A ها و A و S. Okay. And the mother
A
ما أدري كيف أنتوا سويتوا, بس A و B يعني B plus. Okay. So beta. So what is the combination, possible combination of the child? A A A beta plus وإيش بعد A S S beta مش بي اس بي. اوكي سو وات از ذس وات از ذس نوف لا هنا بس بسيط نورمال ايوه ما في ثقل يعني كثير اوكي ذس از نورمال وات از ذس فوزيه اي بي بلس بيتا ثال تريت ها وهذا ها سكل تريت سكل تريت وهذا خلي اعطيها فرصه ما عليه هي شيز اوكي يعني ها ثلاسيميا ايوه سو وات از ات كولد الاسم الصحيح ماله هو اتس ا سيكل سيل ديزيز اوكي سيكل سيل ديزيز اور سيكل بيتا سيكل بيتا بعض الحين نقول سيكل بيتا ونقول ايضا سيكل سيل ديزيز في تعرفوا وات از ذا ديفرنس بين سيكل سيل انيميا اند سيكل سيل ديزيز ما علي بنقيله حاله طيب عرفته فانتوا عارفين المذر والفادر وعارفين الاكسبكتيشن اوف ذا بيبي سو ذس از وات هابن تو ذا بيبي يلا يا قولي ايش هنا هيموغلوبين A 30% هيموغلوبين A2 6.3 هيموغلوبين S 55 هيموغلوبين F 3.5 هو شوي صعب لا سوري I started with the first difficult one it's actually a sickle beta disease okay sickle beta sickle cell disease okay لكن لأن الأس هنا lower as unexpected فدائما انتم في عمان you will see the complicated thing بعدين بعد ما سوينا المذر has what we call the promoter mutation which is make the disease is milder father is standard as sickle cell trait mother has a promoter mutation and that's why you get a sickle beta which is a mild patient is not so symptomatic ليش لانه الاس is not so high and he has 30% A. He's producing 30%. So this is one of these mild mutations. واضح؟ هذه شوية opener, eye opener بالنسبة لكم. Okay. طيب, we'll take another case. Mother is hemoglobin S is 86%. Hemoglobin A, 2 is 7.9. Hemoglobin F is 4.6. سيكل ما تستخدم الكلمه سيكلر اوكي ما حد استخدم انا سيكل سيل اوكي سو سيكل سيل سيكل سيل ديزيز اور سيكل سيل تريت سيكل سيل ديزيز اوكي ناو هل تحبي وود يو لايك تو هازر ا جس وات تايب اوف سيكل سيل ديزيز وات از ذا جينوتايب هنا السؤال بتاعك انت ذس از ا سيكل بيتا واي سيكل بيتا because the A2 is very significant. So A2, انت تقولي متى نعرف انه حقيقي ولا لا? Once the A2 is above 5.5 and maybe 6, then we know almost certain that it's sickle beta, okay? Or in the presence of S. Okay, يا خالصة. احنا سوينا دراسة قمرية عملت دراسة, لكن we really did not separate closely with the HBLC, but anything above 5.5, 6, we start suspecting to be sickle beta. طيب, the father, hemoglobin A, 88.9, hemoglobin A2, 6.2, hemoglobin F, 3.1. لا, ركزي. بيتا ثال تريت. So A2 is the only abnormal. هنا, this is normal. This is 6.2 beta thal trait and 8 A2. فناخذ مرة أخرى chart. The mother, we think it's sickle beta, okay? So S beta. And the father is AB plus or AB naught, okay? AB plus or AB naught, okay? فتعطيني حد يعطيني الكومبينيشن دكتورة؟
AS
عظيم. لا AS وS بيتا أيوة، وبعدين AB وبعدين أيوة زين. ناو فهذه سيكل سيل تريت، وهذه سيكل سيل ديزيز، اوكي، وهذه يس انفورشنتلي، وهذا ذس از ذا بروبلم، ذس بيشنت از سيكل سيل ديزيز، ماذر از سيكل سيل ديزيز، جوت ماريد تو وان جوت ماريد then because after sickle she had one child, he divorced her, so she got married again second time. Now in sickle تعرفوا البنات والأولاد they maybe not looked very well at in the community, so hemoglobin S 56, hemoglobin A2 6.1, hemoglobin F 17.9. now there are some in Oman we see hemoglobin F, what we call high hemoglobin F is quite common يعني for different reasons الأسباب مختلفة. Okay, so what is the diagnosis of the baby? Sickle beta. Patient is sickle beta. Luckily the S is at the moment is on the lower side, but he's a child still, so it may go up, and in fact he's already manifesting, he started to manifest. It's very sad. The mother is sickle disease, very bad, and the child now is sickle cell disease. It's a very serious situation. Mother is admitted at the moment. يعني. That's why I selected this case. Third, it's a nicer one. طيب, نوف تريدي تقولي هذا. So hemoglobin A, 26%. Hemoglobin S, 64.5%. Hemoglobin A2, 5%. And hemoglobin F is 1%. Sickle cell disease, I showed you this for one reason. Why, what attracted your attention? What is lahzi? Anybody? Yeah, but هذا is usually we don't see hemoglobin A in sickle cell disease. So this is high. This patient is probably رسلت ليها أنا رجب من حوالي 10 سنوات is probably sickle beta plus. Okay, so she is producing her own hemoglobin A. Okay, so this is a sickle beta plus. Okay. Now there are haplotypes which are breakpoint for in cleavage sites involving the beta gene recognized by cleavage endonucleases, and there are 4 or 5 what we call haplotypes. So there is the Senegal and the Arab Indian. Senegal is in Senegal, for المكان where it was prescribed or described first, and Arab Indian is in the Arabian Peninsula and in India, في شرق المملكة السعودية, in طائف وقطيف والدمام دمام وقطيف يسمون المنطقة الشرقية, وعمان. Arab Indian, mild disease. Then you have Benin and Cameroon, which are intermediate. Benin في Benin وكاميرون في الكاميرون. Okay, وبانتو فين بانتو؟ Central African Republic. Okay, Central African Republic is the most severe. And unfortunately في عمان, we have Arab Indian, we have Benin, we have Bantu. So we have all the haplotypes. I told you already that alpha effect. Now what makes sickle cell bad and what makes sickle cell good? So there are some parameters that if the hemoglobin is low, it is bad for death, stroke and leg ulcer. If the hemoglobin is high, it's also not good. Okay, and what do we mean by high hemoglobin? 12, 13, 14. I have seen patients with hemoglobin of 15, sickle cell disease. Okay, and this is also not good for them. So hemoglobin high is also not good for pain, acute chest, and AVN. And hemoglobin low is also not good for death and stroke and so on. And what we mean by hemoglobin low is hemoglobin 5, hemoglobin 6. There are patients who their baseline hemoglobin is around that level. These are not good, okay? Because they can get stroke, okay? Low hemoglobin fetal, low fetal hemoglobin is also not good. The higher the fetal hemoglobin, the better is the disease, okay? The higher the hemoglobin F, the better is the disease, okay? واضح? Yes, so low hemoglobin F, risk for death, acute chest and pain and leg ulcers. High white cell is also risk for death and acute chest. And I told you that alpha thalassemia seem to be protective against stroke, but predisposing for AVN. And that's why we don't see a lot of stroke in Oman, and we see a lot of AVN. Okay? Avascular necrosis of the hip. Okay? And then high pain rate is a risk for acute death and AVN, and acute anemia is a high risk for stroke. What do you mean by acute anemia? So if the patient comes with a baseline hemoglobin of 10, and then suddenly it goes to 5, these are quick, you need to transfuse this patient because they can die, okay? And we have seen patients with a hemoglobin of 1.8 and 2 and 2.8 and so on. So these are the patients that you need to help them fast. What are the therapies for sickle? I just want to mention three things. Hydroxyurea. So these are the three. Blood transfusion, hydroxyurea, and bone marrow transplant. These are the three therapeutic. And it reduces, hydroxyurea reduces the white cells, reduces the neutrophils, reduces the monocytes, reduces adhesion molecules, reduces the platelets, reduces the reticulocyte, and you can see that if it does all of these, it makes the disease better. It increases the hemoglobin F, and the higher the hemoglobin F, the better is the disease. And what we know about hydroxyurea, if the patient has a favorable genotype and he's adhering to, then he will do well. If the patient has less favorable genotype and not adhering to, then he will do worse. Okay? What about bone marrow transplant? So bone marrow transplant is the only cure for sickle cell disease, and it's the only cure for thalassemia. Okay? And in sickle, if they had a stroke or they had a event lasting more than 24 hours or acute chest or VOC. In fact, now, if anybody asks us for transplant, we transplant them if they have a donor, okay? Because we don't know. One time they may get crisis and they may die. And this is what we did. We have done about 300 patients so far in the university, not sickle, sickle and everything, okay? And we usually do about 30 cases per year. These are the ages, so we have done as young as 60 days, and we have done 65 years also. Okay, this is out of the hereditary, sickle cell and thalassemia. So thalassemia is the commonest, and then sickle cell disease. And this is our protocol for sickle cell disease. We use a drug called fludarabine, busulfan, and ATG. Don't worry about it. It's called reduced intensity. What does it mean, reduced intensity? That we don't give a lot of chemotherapy. So the patient marrow, what is the idea of giving chemotherapy before transplant? Is to kill those cells. If you give small amount of chemotherapy, less cytotoxic, you allow some of the bone marrow of the patient plus the incoming donor. And the incoming donor marrow is more healthy, and it has a survival advantage, and it will live, whereas the other one will die. Okay? And this is 24 patients. We have transplanted 25 transplants from the age of 17, mean age of 17, but up to 40 years of age. In fact, 40 years of age is a doctor who was transplanted. Okay? And survival is very good, 86%, which is very good for us. We had one death from GVHD, and he was iron overloaded. There are three patients who are rejected. Reject means that their bone marrow does not take, and they, their bone marrow, their own bone marrow comes back, okay? Which is expected in some where we don't do a lot of chemotherapy. That is the risk you get a rejection. You can use the cord blood also, and we are collecting cord blood for this purpose now at the university, and you can freeze it. So this is my last slide, I think last or one before the last. First of all, what is genetic counseling is about? And to, you have done all of these, but is to explain the family and the medical history, assess the chance of the disease occurrence and recurrence. Educate them about the inheritance, about testing, about the management, prevention, and source. And counseling promote informed choices and risk adoption. This is a very sad family. This is my last thing that I want to show you. Very sad family. So the parents are alive, very nice family. Sickle cell trait, tested them. They have three children. One affected, another affected, and one trait. Okay. Now, this child, this boy, Khalid, got married to a sickle cell trait. I don't know. I mean, God only knows why, but that's, okay. And he died. He came to my hospital and screaming, and then suddenly he stopped. And he died. He's about 28 or 29, he died. And has already three children. All of them are sickle cell disease. This boy has a stroke. This lady has a cerebral hemorrhage. This lady is a little bit mild. It's a very sad situation. And the brother goes and marry another sickle cell trait. He gets a disease, gets trait. It's a complicated, why God? Yani. So this is the message that you want to carry to the community, that you need, patients need to be tested and before they get married. And this is my last slide, okay? So this is Oman. So Oman is I call it like a melting pot for hemoglobinopathy. You have thalassemia in Masqat wal Batna. You have sickle cell in Dakhliya wal Sharqiya. You have hemoglobin Dhufar in Dhufar. You have hemoglobin S Oman fi Nakhl wa Dakhliya wal Sharq wal Batna. Wa S Oman is also a dominant two mutations, a Benin variant and a Mediterranean mutation. And hemoglobin Dhufar, I told you, it's a Lebanese and also an African mutation. And we think this Al-Wusta is the Sahara. Well, Sahara has protected maybe Dhufar people from getting sickle. And but I don't know. I mean, this is my interpretation. We think that mosquito limoguda fi salala does not carry malaria. That's a study that we have done some years ago, and maybe that's why sickle cell is not found. If I get a sickle cell from salala, the first question I ask them is, where are they from? If they are from the north or from Yemen. Yalla. So Oman is a melting pot for hemoglobin disorder. Sickle and beta thalassemia contribute to the health burden in the community. Interaction between these disorders create diagnostic challenge. So you have to be very careful for patients whom you are counseling. And better understanding of pathophysiology maybe offer some potential therapeutic. Thank you.
Thank you.
Naam. Showed you some of the complex ones like in the HPLC, but we see also quite straightforward. We see a lot of the straightforward, either beta thalassemia or beta thalassemia trait or sickle cell trait. But we also see some of the complicated one. Unfortunately, that's unfortunate, yani. And you expect it because you have all these. You have. All these interacting mutations together. You have a beta thalassemia and alpha thalassemia and sickle, and then the sickling format and so on, and then milder mutation that we are discovering and so on. So there are so many interacting components, unfortunately.
Is it even
Yes, I don't envy the people who are doing the counseling, because I am also nervous sometimes to tell patient he's completely normal. I'm even nervous to say that, because there's so much of hemoglobinopathies in this country. But the broad one that I don't want people to miss, beta thalate. Alpha, I can't help them. Alpha, I can't. I don't, even I don't want people to test for alpha. But beta thalate has to be, not to be missed. Beta thalate.
The family slide you just saw, because
now, the sad family. No, no. The final message is that if you are not sure, you ask. And many times I'm asking opinions from colleagues. Colleagues who have seen more than me are always better than me, okay? So that is, if you admit that there is something that you, because these people are dependent on you. They are coming for the opinion, and they want a clear opinion from you. And if they have decided, they have taken a lot of pain. They have taken a lot of, to bring the lady for testing. And to تروح وتقول لهم أنا أريد أفحص البنت. No, that is not easy. So they have taken a lot of risk. Now what we are advocating is that we do the testing well before. 20 سنة, 15 سنة عند المدرسة. We do it first. And so we are completely clear. And if they carry a card, we have time. If we do molecular, the molecular is not rapid, it's not done quickly. It may be done in 3 months or 4 months, they are waiting. Not good. So we want to do it early so that it is clear. Patient is clearly labeled that he has alpha or he has beta or has G6PD or sickle and so on. Okay? So be careful, analyze everything. Don't jump into conclusion. Don't do shortcuts. In Oman, ما في shortcut, okay? ما تسوي بس السيكلينج وتقول خل مع السلامة. حتى لو reagent ما موجود, انتظره أو send it somewhere else.
Seems it's very important. They must go on with everything.
بالضبط.